side as you enter, you could see an original Michelangelo, which is done in marble. Michelangelo was an amazing visionary, but the problem is that right now Maria has doesn't have nose because some time while back ago, some crazy person just came out and chopped her nose. Here we are in Basilica, in the main hub of the Christianity, so beware of how you are closed, because usually if you are not fully closed, you cannot exit to the main Basilica. As I said before, Basilica is for free, but obviously you have to understand that there are things that you have to preserve, like you don't bring sharp objects, obviously, because of that. We are a little bit afraid of the music attacks, so that's why nothing has happened here. On the walls, mainly we have major popes, and between them the Cherubini, two small little angels, are having the pope's crown and two keys. On the other side we have properly, we have a Saint Peter. Whenever I come out, I have a two keys. Saint Peter. You had something like this. You were buried in the Vatican. And all the pillars, you had keys. So it's all carved in marble. Vatican, of course. Vatican Basilica is made inside out of beautiful marble from all over Italy, plus everything is in the silver and gold. Before his death, obviously, as you know, he got shot with arrows a lot. Then we have Santo San Paolo II, it's obviously San Paolo John II, there it's very good. It's Pio 12, which has an amazing sculpture of his. He's buried here, and from the other side, it's also another pope. Angels that love the God the most, never criticize his choices and everything. And then suddenly, he said, you know what, I don't want to do that. Very well. Okay, so Vaticano mostly is constructed in Rinascimento style and Barocco. So Rinascimento obviously is something that you should know. A lot of movies were done here, obviously by the Trevi, etc. Especially the movies that come in Rome. And I think one of the latest about John Paul II, we have one of the most important movies done here. So this is the back of the main window in which Pope, every time he faces the crowd from the outside, okay? So every Sunday when the Pope goes outside, he goes from this window here. Yes. From the other part. So you have the inside and outside. Yeah. So there is no place, if you look great, there is no place to to do anything more.
So this is marble, as you see. It's a column of 10 meters at least. And there is no place to go anymore because nothing more than you can add. It's so packed with artifacts.
So there is another book, Innocent.
As you see, one of the most presentation of the devil is a dragon. Okay, so he is represented as the one who defeated the evil. All the lives, biographies of the priests and of the of the you can have easily with in Dubai. There is a book called Biographies of the Papas. You can find out who is better, who is worse. So this is the particular ceiling. All the Renascimento is done with this. This is the particular scene of Renascimento, floral. We have another book. With his own critique. We have one exit. Here obviously with another book, with the crypto and everything. And here we have a Madonna, an iconic Madonna, and the ceiling is all in gold, and the cupola is all in gold. As you see, we have the main altare here, which is done in Rococo style. Under this altar, we have the remains of St. Peter's.
Okay, the tomb of St. Peter, St. Peter's tomb and remains. Okay, and behind us,
we have the altar as in the other churches. It's been projected and done by Bernini himself. Bernini is one of the most important icons of Barocco. He was a Napoletano and students, they done one beautiful thing. They copied San Pietro's this. What you see, it's entirely in gold, so golden altare, and they put it in the church of San Gennaro, the cult of San Gennaro. The blood of San Gennaro is very, very important in Napoli. Why? Because every year they do the they go outside of the church, the procession. Every year they go and do the procession, and in that particular day the blood of San Gennaro became liquid. And once it's not become liquid, something bad will happen. In fact, in one day that it didn't become liquid, sometime after, Napoli had a very, very bad earthquake. So the Seguaci, the people who learned Bernini's style, they've done the copy of this and they put it in the church of San Gennaro in Napoli. Napoli is 1 hour from here, from Rome, and south. If you ever heard about beautiful places like Positano, etc., Napoli lives
lies under that volcano, which if you are a freak of Netflix, you have heard about the eruption of volcano more or less 2,000 years ago. So Ercolano and Pompeii, that happened. On the facade, as I already may told you, there are the apostles, and here we have all the discipoli of Jesus, right? With their we have San Pietro, obviously, we have San Marco, we have Maria, and then we have the four main apostles on this side, which spread the word of Jesus. Jesus, mostly it's like Socrates. Socrates didn't wrote anything by himself, didn't write any of his thoughts that we have from Socrates, we have from other people like Aristoteles, etc., etc. As here, Jesus, he didn't write anything by himself, but his life was explained by four of the life and ideas, obviously, and philosophy was spreaded by four main people. So we have Marco, we have Luca, we have John, and the fourth one I forgot.
Private life for priests.